Hello friends, the last lecture we have got idea about very interesting point, that is correlation. My friends, you know that in last lecture of the unit, that is correlation and regression, in that correlation we have learned about the relationship between the two variables is to be find out, means how to find out or degree of correlation, either there is a positive correlation or negative correlation, or there is no any relation, zero correlation, that is. But one thing I will tell to you, in that actually correlation point we have learned also how to calculate, how to find out the degree of correlation by graphical method and mathematical methods, isn't it? In graphical method also we have studied, and mathematical methods. But now in this today's our regression point, we have to measure of a average relationship between two or more variables in terms of original units of data. My friends, I used to give always one of the example, and that example is nothing but most of time the departments, those which are related with the atmosphere, isn't it, that predicts the raining for this year, that predicts, that word is most important, 90% raining is there in the year, that is a 21, or 100% raining is there in a year 2021. How they are predicting all these things? Because things are to be happened in future. But how they are predicting all these things? They are predicting these things by going through the previous data which is available with their department. My friends, they are predicting the things with the help of the data they are having with them. So they are studying the data of 10 years. Nowadays one of the prediction is there, my friend, after every 10 year there is a drought in Maharashtra, after every 10 year there is a drought in a Maharashtra. So that prediction is on the basis of the previous year study, previous data with them. So in case of this regression also, I will tell to you that when you know the one variable value, you will be able to calculate the value of the another variable. So what is that actually regression? In detail we will see with the help of this unit. Regression is the measure of average relationship between two or more variables in terms of original units of data, my friend. Now in this slide there is a difference between correlation and regression is given to you, because that may be asked in the examination. Correlation is a statistical measure that determines the association or correlationship between two variables. How much that is associated? Positive association, negative association, or there is no association. Also, it represents linear relationship. It represents linear. In case of regression, regression describes how to numerically relates an independent variable to the dependent variable. Means what? I will tell to you. Suppose we are having a data. data of a production of a potato in 10 acres of area. Isn't it? 10 acres of area. So previous data is available with us. But with that one, we have predicted that 150 ton potato in that 10 acre of area. Then what would be the production of a tomato on same year? Isn't it? Although we are having previous data in our hand of that tomato, but for that specific year, suppose we have predicted the production of a potato, that is 150 tons, isn't it? So with the help of that variable, so that variable is a independent variable. Potato, that is tonnage 150, is a independent variable. But with the help of that one, we have to calculate the how much is the production of a tomato. So tomato is a dependent variable. So with the help of regression technique, we have to find out dependent variable with the help of a independent. So relate an independent variable to dependent one. Now another difference is, fit the best lines and one variable based on the one variable is definitely based on the another. Other differences are given here in case of the correlation. Correlation, both the variables x and y are random variables, my friends. Both the variables are random variables. Here x is a random variable, but y is a fixed one. Sometimes both may be random variable. So that is the difference. In case of correlation, both the variables are random variables. In case of regression, one variable is a random, or sometimes both the variables are random. That you have to maybe random. That is another is that in case of correlation find out the degree of relationship between two variables and not the cause and effect of variable. Degree of association or relationship between the two variables can be calculated by using the correlation, but not the cause and effect of variable. Actually, regression indicates the causes and effect relationship between the variable and establishes functional relationship. See the difference. In case of correlation, it is used for testing and verifying the relationship between two variables, gives a limited information. But in case of, we have to say that, regression, it is used for the prediction of one value in relation to the other given value. Got it? So that is the difference between the correlation and regression. In case of the correlation, coefficient correlation lies between plus 1 and minus 1. But in case of coefficient of a regression is an absolute figure, that is not a lies in between the minus 1 and plus 1 as in case of the correlation is there. Correlation is not very useful for further mathematical treatments, but regression values are used for further mathematical treatments. That is the difference, great difference. So you have to keep in mind, in case of correlation, maybe a spurious correlation between the two variables, no spurious regression, no spurious regression we can find. Now my friends, here you will be able to see one of the interesting figure is that y is equal to x plus b, that value. Now however, if the two variables are related, it means that when one changes by a certain amount, the other changes on an average by a certain amount. Keep in mind my friends, as you know that if the two variables are related, it means that when one changes by a certain amount, the other changes on an average by the certain amounts. For example, if we know the weight of fruits and amount of fertilizer supplied are related, then we can find out the amount of fertilizer required to achieve the certain weight. My friends, keep in mind, this example gives us idea about the relationship between the two variables. That is nothing but the, if we know the weight of fruit and amount of fertilizer supplied are related, then we can find amount of fertilizer required to achieve the certain weight. Means, if we are interested to increase the size of mango, we will provide as per our requirement of size of mango fertilizer to that plant. Isn't it? So that is possible. If Y represents a dependent variable, X is the independent variable. This relationship is described as a regression of a Y on X. Y on X in the sense Y is a dependent on X. Y is dependent on X. Now regression equation of a X on Y. So X depend on Y. X is equal to small a plus small b capital Y. A is an unknown constant. B is also unknown constant. A is unknown constant, level of a fitted line. B is an unknown constant, slope of the line. Here, summation X is equal to Na plus B summation Y. Summation XY is equal to A summation Y plus B summation Y square. Now regression equation of a Y on X, Y is equal to ABX, A plus BX, unknown constant small a, level of a fitted line, B is unknown constant, slope of the line, summation Y is equal to NA plus B summation X, summation XY that is equal to A summation X plus B summation X square. From the following data of the yield of tomato and potato in 5 classes, find out the two segregation equations. What is the probable yield of a potato when the yield of tomato happens to be the 150 kilogram? My friends, try to understand first of all the question. I always used to say that try to understand first of all the question and accordingly we have to write the answer of that one. Here, you will find that from the following data of the yield of a tomato of a 5 sites. Tomato 5 sites aplala production kalalela I, isn't it? What is the probability yield of a potato when the yield of a tomato happens to be 150 kilogram? Tomato cha aplyala pahilya site la kiti aahe 60, dusrya 20, tisrya 10, parat 40, parat 80 ani samja 150 jar ekadya thikani asel tar tyacha potato cha utpadan kiti asel, that we want to first of all calculate. Tomato cha aplyala 150 kalala इतने का 90, 60, 50, 80, 120 एंड क्वेश्चन मार्क इज देयर, इजंट इट? हैव यू अंडरस्टूड द क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट? देन हियर सॉल्यूशन, ए रिग्रेशन इक्वेशन इज इक्वल टू वाई ऑन एक्स, वाई इज इक्वल टू ए प्लस बी एक्स, नॉर्मल इक्वेशन समेशन वाई इज इक्वल टू एन ए प्लस स्मॉल बी समेशन एक्स, देन समेशन एक्स वाई इज इक्वल टू स्मॉल ए समेशन एक्स प्लस स्मॉल बी समेशन एक्स स्क्वायर. हियर इज द वैल्यू. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू प्रिपेयर, isn't it? XY as it is we have written. These values are given to us. Summation X 210, summation Y 400, X square, summation X square 12,100, summation Y square 35,000, and XY multiplication that we have taken is nothing but the XY. Sahi Nausak Chopan, this value. Isn't it? Now what should you know? So that value has been there. Then multiplication. 20 into 600. This figure. Then 10 into 50, 500. 14 into 80, 3020. 80 into 120, 9600. So these are the table we have prepared, that is of a X, Y, which is given to us. X square, Y square we have prepared, and X into Y. Now, these values we have to put into the or substitute into the formula. So, these value when we will put like that one, first equation would be the 400 is equal to 5a plus B2210, isn't it? Summation xy is equal to a summation x plus b summation x square, that is equal to 19,000, that is equal to 10a plus b 12,100, second equation. Multiplying equation first by 42, we get, so that is value, that is 16,800 is equal to 210a plus 8,820b. Now subtracting equation 3 from the 2, subtracting equation 3 from 2, so third equation we have taken, second equation tachatna minus kelan aplyala value milali 3100, that is equal to 3280b. So thus b is equal to 3100 divided by 3280, that is b is equal to 0.94. now this 0.94, again substituting value of a b into equation first, pahila equation hai tachyamadhe b chi value ghatli 0.94, that we can see here. Already this was the example equation. In that equation we have added the value of a b. 400 is equal to 5a plus 210 into 0.94, so 5a is equal to 400 minus 197.4, that is equal to 5a is equal to 202.6 divided by, so a value is 400.52, that value is subtracted into y is equal to a plus bx. Then regression equation on y on x. Same way regression equation of x on y, x is equal to a plus by, normal equation as it is. Similar way we have solved this, and finally we have found the b value, that is of a 1003. Here substituting all these values, finally we are going to get a is equal to minus 40 plus 4. Now x is equal to a plus by, x is equal to minus 40.4 into 1.03y, regression equation x on y. So regression equation of a y on x is equal to 40.52 plus 0.94x, regression equation x on y, that is equal to 40.4 plus 1.03y. These two equations are there. What is the probable yield of potato y when the yield of tomato x happens to be the 150 kg? We know that x value, that is tomato value, 150, so y is equal to 40 plus 52 plus 0.94 multiplied by 150. So here, so y is equal to 40 plus 52 151, y is equal to 181.2. when the yield of tomato of x happens to be the 150 kg, the probable yield of a potato y is 182.52 kg. This is the answer. So like that one you will have to solve the problem, so you will understand about the how to get or how to find out the independent variable by using a dependent variable through this regression methodology. With this, my friends, I have to say thank you very much. Again and again I will tell to you, my friends, you will have to always solve the problems, write the problems, do the practice. Practice makes man perfect.